Do you want to learn how to reseat RAM in your desktop PC? Make sure you watch this entire video so you can perform this procedure correctly. Before we begin this tutorial video, we need to cover a few things. Why do we need to reseat our RAM in your desktop PC? Well, on occasion, when you are transporting a computer through the post, sometimes the RAM modules may partially come loose or dislodge itself. Other reasons is that so you can troubleshoot why your RAM is not showing up in the BIOS. What you need for this video is an anti-static wrist strap, so we don't damage the RAM and other electronic components from our static electricity that we may discharge. In this video, we'll be using the Dell Precision 390. First thing you need to do is find the power cord and disconnect it. This Dell Precision case has a latch. Simply give it a tug and the cover should just pop off. This computer has dual channel RAM. You can tell the difference by the two different color tabs, black and white. This one here is dim slot 1. This one here is dim slot 3. This one here is dim slot 2. And this is dim slot 4. Next part is to put our anti-static wrist strap on and clamp it to a metal part of the case. Let's begin reseating RAM. We're going to start with the first dim slot. Push down on the tabs. The RAM should just pop out. Put the RAM back in and push down on the edges with your thumbs, and you should hear a click. Well, in this case, it didn't click. Let's do this for dim slot 3. Take the RAM out, put it in. Push down on the edges and it should clip in place. And we repeat this process for the other two dim slots. Taking dim slot 2 out, reseating it. Making sure the clips are locked in place. And this dim slot 4, which is a bit obscured by the cable. And reseat it by pushing down. Once you're happy with that, take your anti-static wrist strap off, put the cover back on, and push down to close the case. If this process has failed and your RAM does not show up in your BIOS, repeat the process. And then, if that doesn't work, trial and error with different RAM sticks and different DIMM slots until you figure out if you have a faulty DIMM slot or faulty RAM. Become a patron so you can help us continue to provide high quality educational content. If you've already done that, watch our latest video so you can stay up to date with the latest education. Oh, you already done that? Well, we had to ask YouTube to recommend you something else. Go and watch it now. You'll find it very educational.